my darlings. Welcome to a new vlog. I am pretty glammed up today, this morning at least, because I'm gonna try and film two videos today. I have gone all out. I've done the Dyson Airwrap with the barrel attachment, which does take me a little bit longer, but I just love the volume that it gives my hair. And this will last a couple of days. I've also lined my lips. Oh my goodness, I haven't been wearing lipstick in so long because of wearing face masks. Etc. And I've even put on the Eyelure accents, which are like the little half lashes. So I was actually watching my Black Friday videos from last year, and I did have individual lash extensions last year, but I just thought that I would add a little oomph to my eyes. So hopefully it'll look nice with my lights. I've got all the lights set up. I am actually filming my first Black Friday video today, and I know it's super duper early, but this one's gonna be, will you have seen it yet? No, I think I'm gonna put this live next week. Yeah, it's gonna be my kind of tips video. I'm gonna be sharing some little insights as to how I think Black Friday will be different this year because of Corona. So yeah, I have been doing quite a lot of research. I think I'll publish it on Wednesday, so you don't have too long to wait. Obviously, I don't know any discounts yet. Well, actually I do. I do know a few discounts with the retailers that I work closely with across the year, but I'm not allowed to tell you them yet. It is top secrets, but I will be giving a few hints in the video, so definitely check it out when it goes live. My aim is to film two videos today. I also want to film my first Christmas gift guide video, and it's a very different Christmas gift guide video. When is this video going live? So I've got one up today. You might have seen, you may have seen the first Christmas gift guide video, or if not, it's literally the next video going live. So I think I'll film that one downstairs. We've still got the tree from the photo shoot, but more excitingly, we also have our new Christmas tree that has finally arrived. I have to say, I had a little bit of trouble with Balsam Hill. So many of you recommended Balsam Hill for our Christmas tree, and to be fair, the quality of this tree is absolutely amazing. It looks very real. It is the most perfect shape. I think it's the Norwegian spruce. I think that's what it's called. Obviously, I had the problem that was totally my own fault last time with the 12-foot tree. If you know someone that's really tall, chances are they're like 6'5", 6'6". Imagine double that person. That's how big this tree was. And just the base of this tree was like, I don't know, bigger than our entire kitchen in our old house in Clapham. The base of this tree, like the width, the circumference of the base was just huge. So yeah, I did manage to send that back. I was worried. Obviously they said that if it's your own fault, it's not damaged, you have to pay for the postage. So I was a bit nervous, but luckily it was only £15 per box, and there were two boxes. So £30 is the price to pay for my mistake of not thinking about the measurements. But I then went ahead and ordered I think it's a 7.5-foot tree, and this I think is the perfect size. We could have gone a tiny bit bigger, but maybe it would have been too big. I don't know. I feel like the 7.5-foot is perfect. I was watching another vlogger whose videos I've really started to enjoy, Elle Darby. Is that her name? I think, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Elle Darby. She did her Christmas tree decorating and house decorating video. She published it, I think, last night, and I was watching that while I was curling my hair, and it just very much got me in the Christmas spirit. I am expecting a delivery today from Amara, which is a home website. So hopefully that will have lots of baubles and things like that. So if I have any energy left after filming my two videos, then that's what I'm gonna do. So exciting times. I am now, by talking to you, procrastinating from filming my Black Friday predictions video. So I'm gonna get started with that, and I will catch up with you afterwards. Okay, so this is just my tester clip that I'm filming for the vlog, but this is the setup that I'm gonna be doing for the Black Friday video. And guys, I think we finally have the perfect filming setup. You might be able to see in the mirror behind me, giving a bit of a sneak peek here, but I have got, you can see the tripod, and then I've got a ring light directly behind the tripod, and I think that that is the best thing for me to do, because then it like illuminates my entire face, which is perfect, because I was getting still, despite the fact that I've got a falcon eye light here and here, because this room is so big, it is quite a shadowy room, so I was getting some weird lighting, but I think I finally have the perfect lighting setup. Still don't have the perfect sound setup. So what I might do is leave my phone with a little muffler attached recording as well, and then in the editing I can add that in. But I thought I'd give you guys a sneak peek into the filming setup. Let me show you what I'm wearing today. I've got my favourite watch on, my vintage Casio. It really catches the light there. I have got earrings from Missimer. I am hinting here as to the brands that I think are going to have really good deals for Black Friday. Missimer earrings. Love these, and then Missimer necklace as well. This is my really lovely cozy jumper from Reese. And then I have got this lovely, oh, did I say these were Missimer, the rings? These are actually Mejuri. I need to add a little bit more fake tan to my hands. And then this really delicate fine bracelet, which has got this really lovely thin chain and these tiny little pearls, that is from Mejuri as well. So this, and then I've just got leggings on underneath. Can you see my reflection in the mirror? Leggings and slippers, because no one's gonna see that bit. Right, I'm procrastinating again. I'm gonna start filming. I will see you in about an hour. Okay, an hour later, and I think that was a success. Honestly, I had to go and sit down for 10 minutes and just breathe after filming that. I don't think I took a breath throughout that whole video. It was quite intense. I get quite carried away when I do my fashion videos. I do miss doing my fashion videos, but there will be a lot coming your way. I've got lipstick all over my water bottle. I've just downed that much of my bottle after filming, because I don't tend to take breaks when I'm doing the videos. I'll just keep talking and talking and talking, and it makes me very thirsty. Okay, so now I have caught my breath, recovered. I'm gonna go and put my memory card in my laptop straight away, because I don't wanna lose everything I've just filmed. And then I'm gonna have some lunch and then create a setup to film my first Christmas gift guide downstairs in the drawing room. What delights do we have for luncheon today?
Cheating, aren't we? Well, some quince and clover. Yeah, we're cheating in that we've not made it.
No.
Is that enough?
Yes. Looks very colourful and healthy, thank you, darling. Oh, little boy. Yuma. I thought I would try something a little bit different with my coffee. I want to try and make it a little bit more festive, seeing as I'm about to film a Christmas video. So I thought I would pop in a little bit of ground cinnamon. This is a total DIY recipe, by the way, but I love cinnamon. Come on. Ooh. And a little bit of ground nutmeg as well. I'm sure in Starbucks they add it as a syrup, but I think that could be rather lovely, a nice little festive touch to my afternoon latte macchiato. Well, it most definitely smells festive, that's for sure. Okay, I am now going to bring my lights and camera action tripod and all the gifts for my first gift guide into the drawing room, and I will show you my festive gift guide video set up once I have set it up. Okay, darlings, are you ready to see the absolute Christmas bomb site that is our current drawing room? Are you ready for this? Dun, dun, dun. Yes. Oh, we have a puppy escape artist. You two have become really naughty lately. You've become really naughty. You know you're not allowed through here. Come on. Come on, Terrible. Back, back, back. Back we go. Da, 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 da. Naughty boy. Where were we? Okay, yes, it's a huge mess in here because we are switching from photo shoot tree, which obviously we had to put up in a rush, to real tree, not real, our fake real tree, which, as I said, I think is the perfect size. It's still pretty voluminous, pretty round at the base, but I'm really, really pleased with the quality. It does, like, it really does look and almost feel real. It just doesn't smell like a real tree. Maybe I'll get some Christmas tree diffusers in here, but it looks absolutely fabulous. As you can see, it's like a pre-lit tree. I think I probably need to pull out the branches a little bit more, But I'm excited to hopefully decorate this a little bit later. Yeah, they definitely need just fanning out a little bit because you can just see there, what's the word? The shape at the moment makes it look a little bit more fake because they're all in their clusters. But I am chuffed with that. I will leave the exact one that this is linked down below in case anyone is interested. So I think this is my tripod. I think I will create a little corner here. Let's see, how would that look as a setup? So I need to go, Yeah, maybe that kind of setup would be nice. I'll bring Nigel the Nutcracker into the shot as well. He's currently tucked away over here. We've also got all of our Christmas decorations down from the loft, including our light up Dachshund. Okay, I'm gonna go and bring my lights down and then create the perfect festive filming setup. Okay, it's about 2 hours later now, and wow, that took it out of me. I was very energetic for that video, and once again, I feel like I have crashed. This is the mess that I now have to deal with, giving you a major sneak peek into some of the bits that I'll be featuring. You may have already seen this video, actually. But yeah, when I'm filming, I just create so much mess because I'm on such a roll that I never tidy up as I go along. So now I have this bomb site to deal with and the rest of the room. Oh my goodness. It's going to take a Christmas miracle to get this room looking beautiful and festive and relaxing and wonderful, because right now it looks like a tip. So I'm going to pop on some Christmas YouTube videos. My favorites are already uploading Christmas content, and start the massive tidy up progress. Lovely little doggies. Yes,
boy.
You are. I love you so much. Okay, we're back from our sunset dog walk, and Charlie has just prepared dinner. It looks amazing, but Charlie has just said, "Josie, I think this dinner is about to change your life." So, what actually is it, darling?
It's basically a Geniola recipe. It is called cauliflower cheese pasta.
Right.
So it's basically like a hybrid of everything that's good about cauliflower cheese and everything that's good about mac and cheese together. And in theory, it's a lot quicker than either dish as well, because it combines the two, but it actually cuts out the time. So in a way, if you had help, which I didn't, but if you had help...
You did! Dexy was helping you the whole way.
It probably only take 20 minutes from start to finish if I'd had help. So you've got breadcrumbs, you've got all the green bits of leaves from the cauliflower, toasted with garlic.
Ooh.
And then you have A cauliflower infused milky cheesy sauce.
Wow. Okay, I can't talk about it anymore. I need to get excited, get involved. Good morning, my darlings. As you may have predicted, last night's dinner was so good, but wow, did I feel bloated after that. Oh my gosh. So we have just been for a little fresh air walk. That's the only thing we're allowed to do during lockdown. And we decided to go somewhere that we've not been before. You'll have just seen some clips, and those are the Rollright Stones and the Kingstone. It's kind of like a mini version of Stonehenge here in the Cotswolds. It's actually a sacred, I think, burial area. I definitely need to do a little bit more research, but normally when we've driven past, because it's between our favourite garden centre and Daylesford, so when we've driven past there in the past, there have been so many cars, we've always been like, what is it? What's there? So we decided to go and check it out, and where it was like early morning mist, it was just quite eerie actually, very spiritual place. Back home now, I am craving a cinnamon roll. So I might see if we've got the ingredients for me to make one in the Thermomix, because I feel like that would be perfect. Freshly made cinnamon roll with a cup of coffee. But before I do that, I need to do a little bit of urgent work. So I'm sat here by the fire, get a bit of work done with my pal. You're ridiculous. You are ridiculous.
Over a variety of years.
Okay, we've had our lunch. We had the rest of the salad that Charlie picked up from Quince and Clover yesterday, and now we are on an exciting outing to the garden centre, because thankfully this lockdown garden centres are allowed to stay open. I don't know why. Do you know why they're allowed to stay
open? I think it's because I don't think every garden centre's open. I could be wrong. I think it's ones that sell food, because they sell food there, and they sell pet food, they sell like what are essential supplies. But I could be wrong. I think that's maybe the justification for it.
Right.
To be fair, Wyatt's and a few other garden centres were open during the last lockdown.
Yeah.
But Nicholson's wasn't, for whatever reason.
Interesting. So that's where we're going. We need to get some plants, some bushes. I've got changed into a full Topshop outfit because I have to take some Instagram stories for them. So hopefully we're going to find somewhere fairly scenic en route. Very, very snugly. This is my biggest teddy coat from Topshop. And of course, we'll see if they've got any Christmas decorations there as well, because hopefully this evening we'll finally get round to doing our decoration, decluttering and organising, because I have actually had a delivery. My Amara delivery has arrived, so there'll be a Christmas unboxing when we get home as well. I think that people don't realise that garden centres are open, because we are quite literally the only ones here. It's absolutely crazy. What have you spotted? Is it a good time of year to plant lavender though?
It's fine.
Really? So we're finding some bedding plants to pop in the troughs outside the front gates of the house. What's this? A Lisa Rose. Viburnum.
Okay.
It's quite nice having the place to ourselves, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I'm thinking we might have got a bit carried away, but we'll find places for all of this, yeah?
Yeah, I think maybe we should stop.
Yeah, that's enough now. I think about two-thirds of that will fit.
Great.
That'd be too cramped. I'm wondering maybe.
Thank you. Hello again, darlings. Back from the garden centre. Friday night, I have put the laptop down and we are having burgers again. So sadly, not Honest Burgers. I say sadly, these could end up being even nicer than Honest Burgers. Basically, the lovely, I feel like I've spoken about it so much in this vlog, the lovely Quince and Clover at Great Tew, which is right by the Soho farmhouse. They've obviously like closed their cafe for Corona lockdown, but they are doing takeaway burgers on Fridays. So we placed our order and Charlie's just gone to get them. So I am making the chips. I'm following Jamie Oliver's recipe. I have just realized that I look like a gangster with my chain and my top. I feel like with chain necklaces, you have to be quite careful what you wear them with. Obviously my dress earlier, it was absolutely perfect. I love this one. It is one from Missima. But yeah, with a high neck jumper, it looks a little bit gangster. Obviously, wearing a pink leopard print jumper is the complete opposite of gangster. But anyway, so I have got my chips boiling away on the agar. I'm just gonna lightly boil them like you kind of would a roast potato, and then I'm gonna pop them in the oil. I've realized that throughout this video I have said that we're gonna be doing Christmas decorating and Christmas decluttering, and it just hasn't happened. This week has been a busy work week, and I feel like this vlog is now, because it's 2 days, going to have been quite long. But I have been watching some American YouTubers, and they do full dedicated videos, not like sprinkled into a vlog, but like I've seen and I've been watching some fully dedicated videos for American YouTubers getting their houses ready for Christmas, and it's just so lovely and wholesome to watch. Like, they're making their cinnamon rolls, they're making their hot chocolate, and they're getting the tree ready. So I think that's what I'm gonna do tomorrow. It's a Saturday tomorrow. I'm gonna bake some cinnamon rolls first thing, make myself a hot chocolate, and have a really lovely festive day. So I hope that that will be worth the wait. I'm sorry that I have dangled the carrot so much in today's video. You're looking at me asking for your dinner when actually I think your brother's eaten your dinner. Should we go and have a look, little Dickie? Come on. Yes, Dexy's eaten your dinner. You were too slow, young man. Come on, let me get you some more. Not you, Dexy. Dexy is so naughty. He keeps eating his brother's dinner. Right. You need to stop being a piglet, mister, because you're going to get fatty bum bum and your brother's going to go hungry. Let's do some dinner for Dicky. The boys have now decided that the only flavour of Lily's Kitchen that they like is cottage pie. Okay, and they do also like Sunday lunch, but they've decided that they no longer like lamb hot pot. They definitely don't like chicken casserole anymore. These boys are just such little drama queens. I'm going to give you a little bit, my little Dickie, because I feel like you might... Do any other dog owners have a separate fork for their dog food? I feel like I just don't love the idea of using a fork that we eat and our guests eat from when I'm doing the dog food. So this has come from my old house in Ross-on-Wye, which is where I lived the 10 years before I moved into our little house in Clapham. This fork has come with me through all of those houses, and it is officially the dog fork. I've only got one left. I used to have loads. It's a really thin one. So I would never mix that up with forks that we use. Okay, come on then, little monkey. This is for Dickie only. Right, Dexy, you come with me. I'll create a distraction. Dickie, enjoy your dinner, young man. No, you stay in here. No, that's the empty bowl. Goodness me, you are peculiar. You had me at a low. 'Cause where you go is where I go. I don't need nobody else.